Satanaga first, as per usual. Their bans throughout this series has been Warlock and Naga Siren. Still did this, and no idea what Warlock was. 10 seconds. And Dota 1? Anyone?
Can you speak louder? It's like some issue.
Do you know what Warlock's Dota 1 name was?
I think I know a little bit. I don't know how to. It's top of my head, I can't think. It's something Lanik, right? Or
I think you're wrong.
Sounds something like.
What do you do?
Something like Demon.
Demon?
It's also wrong. It's something with R, that's all I can tell you.
OG goes for
I'll
the Shadow Demon.
That one out for you guys.
Yeah. OG bans out the Shadow Demon. I think they did that last game as well.
Yeah, after the first game of the series, they seemed to not want to play.
So, I mean, this is the kind of scenario you.
I actually don't know how to pronounce
wait,
that.
Wait, let me see.
I was right a little bit, huh?
What was it?
Give it to hold me. On.
No,
dude, hold on. It's there. Right there. You cannot scroll down. Just went back.
Just keeps improving.
Just scroll down. Demnok Lanik, the Warlock. All
right. That sounds like something I've never heard of.
Yeah, I've never heard that
either.
Before.
I've heard it.
I'm pretty sure it's wrong.
All right,
so it did leave draw, like you said.
OG decided to ban Ogre.
Yeah.
I think that's a good decision.
Oh, maybe they're anticipating. Maybe VP thinks Lifesteer is good versus draw, and they're anticipating the Lifesteer or the Draw Ranger to come out.
I think they just want to put the pressure on OG to make a decision on what to play.
Yeah.
VP doesn't have to pick the draw right away.
Yeah.
They can just pick this sort of.
They know that OG don't want to play draw. Like they, it's pretty obvious that OG is just like banking on VP picking draw so they can play against it.
Yeah.
So VP is just playing a normal game, picking the hero that's pretty solid for them. They played on both support and offlane, so.
Yeah, it's just an open hero for them. It doesn't really show anything what
they
want to do.
Have they done draw ranger and slaughter on the same team before?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and say
I think they have.
I think they did it when they had Weaver, they had slaughter too.
Interesting.
Yeah, it was offline sort of that game.
So they are just open. Right
it's
now.
A very good decision for them actually, because they can still pick draw as the next pick, and they'll see two more heroes and have like response bans to it. So good decision by VP.
So OG's kind of caught off guard here, going into the reserve time already.
Yeah, they're basically committing to what do we want to do.
I mean, I'm pretty sure they're gonna. They'll definitely pick bat. I think. These guys pretty much pick bat every time it's available.
Is this where the Venomancer comes out, guys?
We'll see. I doubt it.
I doubt it too. I think. Usually, I think what teams would do in this kind of scenario is to just, like, gather up, say, like, let's go back to what we do pretty much all the time when we get this hero. Let's, like, resort to our old stuff.
Yeah.
And for OG, I think their strongest suit is, like, Bat and Drow.
Yeah, I think that's one option. The other option is just going YOLO.
YOLO.
So what would they pick with this bat? I mean, we would probably pick something with like a dirge or something with this bat rider in our opening too.
That is an option for
them. They might look undying.
But I've not seen Jerix play a ton of that hero.
Dirge can be good against starter.
I think it's a bad sign though. If they don't pick draw here, I think it's just like.
I think
they would.
No, but the thing is, OG is very comfortable with playing bat against draw too. So they don't really have to pick the draw, I think.
And the fact that they're taking so long, I don't think they're going to go for the draw.
I mean, they're definitely thinking about something, so...
I think they pick draw.
Something like, do we pick draw or do we not? Like
they're definitely thinking
oh,
about...
Oh, good one, man. Well done.
So...
There's no way this is a good sign going 45 seconds reserve time.
No, I mean, they're caught off guard here because they lost the two series with two different ideas. Going into the third one, they thought... Most likely, their thought was that VP was going to first pick draw. If they gave it to them, but they didn't. And now they have to make... They pretty much have to base their entire game plan off these two first picks, which is very difficult to do. It's really usually not something you want to do. You want to leave your draft a bit more open so that you don't have to bank everything on your first two.
They're going very deep in reserve time.
Yeah, I think you definitely just lose with what you got.
Oh,
so they go for the Wisp, so they do something different.
Alright, insta-pick the Lifestealer.
Yeah.
I mean, that was pretty straightforward for them.
So
the pressure is on right here, actually.
Draw goes through the first phase for the first time in approximately...
First time in
2016, I think. First time in 2016.
2016, I wouldn't... sure. And OG has not been prioritizing those hero throughout this tournament, or the past tournament, I think.
IO?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess it's kind of hard to say. I'm not sure if it's been banned against them, but I mean, playing us for example.
Do you think VP's
gonna
ban draw second phase? Or they just don't give a single hoot.
I don't think VP VP can't go for the draw anymore, right? Because they already have the lifestyle.
No,
that was pretty much impossible.
I don't think they're scared of draw at all with these two heroes either.
Yeah. And I don't think OG will go for draw. Bat Wisp plus draw does not really strike me as something you would really want.
Like I think it's pretty strong.
It's okay.
I think it's pretty strong.
I think it just depends on their confidence, because right now, I'm pretty sure VP's like baiting them. They're like, pick the draw, we're going to own you or something. But they could just be like, no, our draw owns, bro. And then we'll just figure it out.
Does that look like the face of a man who wants to play Draw Ranger?
Which he's not the draw player, though. Eh?
Oh, no, he's not.
The draw player back there?
Yeah, yeah, oh, back there. Didn't see him back there.
That's some bad posture, man.
It's like the one picture of you where you're like this.
Yeah, I remember.
No, he wants to play, I guess, Enigma right now.
Enigma?
Yeah.
So we'll see if they go for the draw here. Actually, if they wanted to go for the draw, they probably would leave it for 4th or 5th.
Oh, yeah, I think a really good option here would be for them to take draw right now and then take deuce on the next pick.
I think OG don't have to do draw here. I think a better option for them, tree is a
they could still draw.
Solid option.
Tree is pretty solid,
I think. Dude, they're just insta-picking.
Yeah, they're picking very fast.
Tree is very confident, but I think if OG goes into like something as simple as like a Sven here, it's super good for them, because I feel like the Stata lifestyle is a decent opening, but it's not like...
It's not super strong.
It's not that hard to counter. Like, tree is a good start. Like, you remove some of the burst, and then you put a Sven in there, you already have Wisp to partner up with it. I feel like that would be like a better way to go for OG. Like, just keep the draft simple and not like...
Overthink things.
Yeah,
all mental things aside, I like OG's draft right now. Like,
yeah,
I don't know how they're feeling right now. They're probably feeling sort of defeated, even though I think from an outsider perspective, their draft looks very good.
So if Nyx and Star jump on you and you tree armor the guy, does he live or what happens?
It depends.
Tough to say.
What do you think of the TA pick there?
TA is like a super good pick because she cannot be burst down by Nyx and Slaughter.
But isn't she pretty vulnerable to getting counterpicked here in these two upcoming picks?
That is the problem. I think OG wanted TA for sure as in their draft, but the problem for them was that they didn't know what to pick in this, like on this spot, and they only had like 1 second left. They did already have 1 second left, so
it's tough
also
to pick
the thing
TA
is she cannot be countered that easily, right? Because they have tree and Wisp to back him up.
That's true. They have good roamers. So. And tree plus TA. Actually, how is it that the armor interacts?
Refraction charges don't go down, I think.
Is that how it works?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's how it works.
That's pretty broken, bro.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
So it goes through living armor first?
Yeah, then...
Oh, that's a VP classic. I'm not too sure if I like that in this game, to be honest, because OG have a bad rider, which is rather good against Inch, and then they have two supports that can just run around, you know, wisping it.
Yeah, it's going to be hard for Inch to get stuff done,
yeah,
I think.
Like, wisping tree can just run around. They don't really care about the Inch, you know, they can just outrun her. And then TA might have some issues, but, you know, it's a mid laner. And then if they pick a strong side laner here, OG, then I think they won't have too much issues with the Inch.
What do you think the ban's going to be for VP?
Might just ban the Sven. I think that's a pretty good ban.
Well, Sven's a pretty good ban.
I think Sven is a pretty obvious ban for them.
I mean, but the thing is...
They won't ban Sven.
I don't think they're going to pick Sven, because then they have TA and Sven.
The problem for OG... Right,
they did it.
Sorry.
And then VP's last pick, they need a midliner. If you're on Virtus.Pro, and you are going, you're going up against TA...
No one's asking for Viper right now.
For Viper?
Yes, sir.
No way, dude.
No one's like, give me Viper, I own this game. Exact words. In Russian.
Nah, he's probably asking for Storm, dude.
Storm's bad.
Actually,
no, Storm's
bad. Let me tell you the pick. It's Cardinal Sharpie.
Yeah, it's...
Sniper?
Sniper's a pretty good pick here.
It's a very good
it's
pick.
It's a very
this
strong pick.
I'm not too sure about it.
Well, you are wrong, good sir.
Why, though?
Because they already have Batrider, and TA can work as a gap closer eventually, and they have one...
Do you think Purple cares about that?
I think ideally...
I think he does.
that
is a good pick here.
That is a very bad pick, I would say.
Okay.
He's going to get destroyed by Vizky in middle lane.
That is the Chaos Knight.
So basically, OG just going to pick themselves.
Now I've seen it all.
You think so?
Yeah, they picked CK into Ember, I don't know.
Well, they pretty much snap picked it.
It is pretty bad, I would say.
It's not that bad.
What is
no, this is,
game?
Guys, this is a throwback. We got some CK Wisp up in the house right now. 2016
CK.
Hero
in the game right now?
For sure. Chaos Knight. Ember takes the prize actually over CK.
I don't think so.
CK
you're
is
wrong.
A good hero, guys.
You're just wrong on many levels, sir.
Now, let me tell you the worst hero in the game. You want to guess? You get one guess each. The worst hero in the game. You start crit, and then we go like this.
Start the universe?
No, Westria. I mean,
it's definitely techies.
Not techies?
No, no, I will answer the last.
Okay, so.
The fish.
It's the fish. You won.
I won. That's Slark for people who don't know.
Slark is the most worthless hero in Dota 2, and if you pick it, you two are worthless.
Whoa.
Oh, that's pretty shade, bro.
That is some shade.
Man, you gotta take that, man.
Alright, so, the game has begun.
The classic TP smoke TP here from VP. I think the reason OG didn't TP is because they're gonna smoke.
They're gonna
OG's
smoke.
Going for the
smoke, eh? Smoker.
They're gonna smoke, they're gonna run into the VP jungle here.
It's called smoke.
But Solo just bought 5 branches.
I mean, this is nice. VP you're down 2 games and you're just going for a play like this.
VP is scouting it.
They're aware.
Have fun, boys! They're going for this anyway,
man. He's not gonna die.
I think he's gonna die.
He's dead.
Oh,
shit.
He's killed Mel.
He's good. Where is he going, dude?
He's dead, dude.
This is some good stuff.
Wait, why did he run that way?
This is some game 3.
He got glimpsed, dude.
He's gonna melt here. He's good.
Oh, he's fine. Oh, the Shinji. No Shinji.
This is some hype.
Oh, the stun.
No, dude.
Dude, they have so much armor off these towers.
He's just invis there.
He's melting like crazy.
Oh, actually, you're right. The towers are getting 3
armor.
Oh, the tower armor.
That's actually so significant. Good call.
Thank you.
Oh, he has 8 stacks on him, dude. That's rough.
Oh, my God.
Ember's back, though.
Ember's comeback.
I feel like both games we've watched, though, has just been some crazy level 1 fights.
Yeah, but that's what we live for.
Get the batch.
He's the tower armor coming into play, 7 HP.
Oh, the tree block.
So high.
Oh, nice try.
Oh, the armor. Oh,
no. The enchant.
The armor again.
And we can hear the Russian commentators going crazy right now.
That was
pretty interesting to watch.
We don't really go crazy.
I tried to go crazy there. Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it.
Wait, who got the first blood? The Ember died, right? Right away?
Yeah. Chaos Knight first blood.
Yeah.
Alright.
I would say...
He has boots. He's support now.
What is your opinion on this middle lane matchup, Sumel?
I would say player dependent.
What if you skill melt first? Is that significant?
The better player wins this matchup.
Okay.
But the problem is he has a melt.
Yeah. But
that's an issue.
But going like multiple levels in melt is not too bad in this lane, right? It's just not good to have the.
I don't think it's good because you need the farm stacks after.
Like, cause if you have refraction, you can just man fight anyways.
Maybe you go for the old school build, which is like 1-4-1, and then you go melt, and then you hit him, and you melt again, and you get a solo.
No,
kill.
Sir, you're wrong.
No, I will go ahead and agree with Sai here.
Yeah, I think that's what you have to resort to.
That's why you guys are not the mid players.
That is true.
I think there's a lot of pressure on this Ench right now to get things done in the Lancer.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure, and it's not that easy. Like, she like missteps, she can easily die. Oh my God.
I don't think he's dead at all. He's fine. He's alright.
I'm not too sure if he's fine here, guys.
I think
he seated the back.
Or
W, whatever.
Oh my.
Just
some run at them, Doto.
Well, Ench is gonna go into the dire jungle. He probably wants to help up both mid and top lane.
This is a good move by.
He's gonna run into mid lane.
Yeah, this is a good move.
He's very far.
Does he have a sentry?
No sentry.
That is why you get multiple one, bro.
Oh, the Seder Blast.
Oh!
He's okay.
He's not okay.
Oh! Meanwhile, though,
CK will go down here.
That's not a good
trade. We're not missing a single thing, man. This camera
works. This is some great top-notch camera work by Webpuzz, I believe. Good job.
Oh, nice job, man.
Easy weapons,
right? Alright.
Cameraman?
Credit where it's due.
Every time we die, they just look away.
Alright, everyone shut up for a second.
Sorry.
So, the direction this game has taken is that the lanes are kind of stable as of now after that.
No, the thing is...
Disastrous level 1 engagement,
I'm so distracted by TS skill build.
Well, he can't...
No point in infraction.
Well, that's what I said. He understands what he needs to do this game,
I don't think he's gonna die to this, right?
I think he is gonna die.
He's
it's not that much damage.
You know
there's a blast.
He's gonna die to the blast.
Oh, that's unfortunate, bro.
Just imagine if you had infraction level 1. Just one level.
Yeah, I mean, I think the idea OG had by putting their challenge bot lane was a good because it makes the bat safe on the top lane against the Ench, but their mid laner is very exposed.
But
that's the problem with picking TA generally. Like,
yeah.
It's super easy to gank if you just have a hero like Ember.
Yeah, but I think they botched the bottom lane up a bit. I don't think CK should have died like that.
Yeah. The problem was, I think when they went before, he didn't have Stout Shield on CK.
Yeah.
I think he had like Boots Stick, right?
Yeah.
That's actually quite a low percentage play.
Might be going down.
Yeah.
He's not skilling anything.
This Ench is doing a lot of work this game. Yeah.
I mean, this is what happens when you go aggro, and then Ench is on the opposite side of the map. I mean, and you have these souls who aren't really very independent. It's not like you have a Tidehunter or a Timbersaw who can sit in their lane.
I would say Batrider is
I think what VP did well in this game is that they put the starter safe lane.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Put the life steer against the Batrider. Because that's actually like a lane that's good for Bat to gank. Because Life Surge just runs up, open wounds, and it's a good setup for Ench.
I mean, they don't mind that all that starters don't give them any.
Is he dead here? Oh, he could have mill striked him. He would have died. To mill opinion?
Amber was dead. That was a misplay there by.
Oh, he's had a rough game so far.
Yeah,
so.
But he's doing decent in CS despite having 3 deaths, I think he has.
Yeah, he's probably using that level 2 melt to guarantee himself some last hits.
Please run.
He's actually dead.
He's gonna dodge it. Nice.
Oh, the sentry.
Too late with
not
the placement.
Fast enough.
That was beautiful to watch.
Do you believe he was dead?
Yeah, I think he was dead, actually.
I don't think this is too bad for G, though.
No, it's not.
Actually, that's bottom.
Can we check the Dire Ancients as if they've been stacked? They have not, okay.
I think this game is pretty.
You can't even do that, actually.
G, I would say. Because in this game, T needs to be ahead. And she is like.
Yeah. They're gonna dive bottom though. They have 4 heroes here.
Nice sir, TP bottom.
Good TP, really good TP.
Oh, they're both dead, dude.
They are both dead.
It's a really good TP from the Life Surge.
Yeah.
And I think Life Surge is gonna chase him down.
What do you think about Ramzy 666 hardcore?
I mean, he's definitely one of the best carries right now. Look at him go.
I don't care.
Hunted, is he gonna land the slipper? Yes, he will.
Of course he will.
And S4 will go down, and that's three. Is it 3 heroes?
It's
or 2
another
heroes
game
dying?
Where there's
it was
14
three
kills in minus 5.
3
I
heroes
think
dying.
Just buying a Midas?
That's not a Midas.
My bad.
That would have been.
Quite have been
it would have been really good for him if that was a Midas recipe. Oh my
no.
God.
Baited by the safe. I don't know if. They can come back from this one. At least,
yes,
at least mentally.
At least they come back.
It's 5 minutes.
That's fine. I'm sorry.
It's very early.
Yo, Arthur, stop being negative.
I'm not being negative.
I mean, they are feeding quite a few kills their way.
What happened to you?
No, I didn't think they can actually. They can still win this game very easily. Right. But I'm just saying, mentally, they may be checked out.
Well, it's hard because they're. It's the final game of the series. Yeah. If they go, it's on match point for Virtus.Pro.
This does look like some super, like mental shit.
I mean, obviously OG wasn't satisfied with the way the draft went in the beginning, but I think as for now.
Oh, good play by S4.
He's checked in.
Obviously, VP is off to the better start, following the level 1 engagement, and then Enchantress roaming on the lanes.
The
VP
only problem I see in this game is that Dire have a Chaos Knight.
That's not a problem.
That's not a problem.
No, I don't think that's a problem.
That's a huge problem.
No, CK's not that bad of a hero that you can't pick him, especially with a hero like Wisp.
I mean, CK is a worse hero than the Fish.
No.
Which makes him pretty bad.
That's just not true.
That is just your opinion.
Like, they had to go for something that they go aggro with, and it had to combo with Wisp. Their go-to pick would have been Sven, but Sven was banned out. And
yeah, which is, that makes me wonder like, why did they want the TA so bad?
They could have picked Meepo and it would have been better.
Okay,
than
okay, we got all
right, you gotta shut up.
Yeah.
I don't think you can completely blame the pick right here. I think
yeah.
I'm triggered.
I mean, the entire thing on level 1 made their lanes a lot worse than they had to do.
There's been a lot of stuff going on this game.
Like, TA did not have to skill Meld.
It feels like OG thought they had to like overcompensate for something. Like, they're like doing this like, super aggro moves and like. TA like keeps on going to the lane and stuff, but I feel like they just need to like chill.
They might go on him here.
Take a breather.
His rage is CD for 5 more seconds, but they're having trouble with these creeps here.
Yeah.
Amber's TP'd in.
He's blocked.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit. He's fine though.
Oh, he got him.
Fine though.
They don't really have anything to get this flame shield off though.
That was actually. It can still be really bad.
It could have been way worse actually.
I think Baron is gonna do a lot here though.
Which one? He's doing it.
I think he's
dead. He's doing it.
Oh, he's gonna be fine, but that was not too bad for OG. He got a life steal and a tower kill on CK.
What does OG need to do right now to get back into it? What they like need mentally
to
at least.
I mean, what they need to do is they...
They need to get this guy back into the game.
Yeah, they need to give him
the
some
problem
space.
I see with this is that his skill, he can't really farm the Ancient Star. Yeah, he doesn't farm that fast. That's the problem with this max meld thing.
Yeah, I mean, the problem is he went for a very lane dominant build and did not really dominate his lane.
It doesn't make much sense to go max meld against like an Enchantress and Ember, I feel like. Because even though you might win in CS, if you die once...
CK is teleporting in, but he's far too late.
Oh, is he gonna cancel? Oh, he is scared.
Because Leicester was on his way. If he would have teleported in, he would have died as well, so he could call and cancel.
I think S4 has gotta make something happen.
So I think
S4 and Wisp.
I mean, OG really need to go to the bottom lane right now, because they know both Sutter and Leicester are TP top. And there's just the disruptor sitting down there.
He's not gonna die.
I think it's really important that OG try to.
She's still not.
They found the disruption. That's a 4-second stun. Very
pretty
nice RNG from an until there.
Actually, he's the lowest net worth in the game. I'm lying.
Well, it's
not a big kill.
It's still 400 gold for this Wisp.
It's a mental.
No, it's nice.
Mental
it's
bonus right there.
It's a very nice kill.
If you're a Wisp, you would know.
Yeah. Sorry.
It's a very nice kill. Like, that's gonna give him his urn or whatever he wants to go.
He has a urn. He has two urn charges now.
Then he's gonna get boots. He has two urn charges. He's happy.
Yeah. He's a happy boy.
Actually, he's not happy. He's like slightly amused. It's a long way from being happy.
Can we check Wisp's level?
Plus 5.
Almost 6.
Yeah.
They should have a tome coming up here. Yeah. Spawns at 10.
That
right?
is definitely for the trend, I think.
Oh, they spawned them.
Trained this. I don't think he's having that good of a game on Trient. He probably needs to get some levels in armor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Level 4.
If he gets.
They're gonna find the CK.
They have relocate.
No,
there's a relocate.
They got it.
Nice play. Jerks will probably go down. Let's see if he attempts. He's gonna attempt
the teleport thing.
Alright, let's go for it.
He's not doing it.
Alright, disappointed.
He's good though.
He's fine.
He's not fine. Jerks will go down here.
No.
Okay. He's
not fine.
Sorry.
Well, you gotta believe.
Honestly though, I think Orange made this thing happen, I think. The way he played the early game kind of set up all of this.
Yeah.
I mean, he realized where he came.
Yeah. I mean, like, he did a lot of work this game.
I think the way that they laned, especially like putting the Leicester top, this makes it easy just for them to sit bottom and not die and start against levels. Really well played out of VP so far.
Don't you think if Dara played the lane like perfectly or something, they could have done way better in the bottom lane?
Well, I think the level 1 stuff kind of screwed up with their like idea of the game per se.
I think the problem is that OG's Wisp Trilane is only really intended to run at them in the lane, so they kind of have to make aggro moves.
The problem is that the Trilane doesn't really do well against the Slaughter.
Yeah. It's not great. Slaughter's pretty tanky in them.
I mean, they could have done way better, obviously, but...
Yeah, but I think it's still a very hard lane for them to be in, because if VP manages to control the side pull, there's very little OG can do but go on them.
Yeah.
And then every time they go on them, there's a chance that they...
But on paper, though, when you look at Disruptor, Slaughter, and you have vision of your jungle, so you know where the Enchantress is, and you have a Tree Wisp and Chaos Knight.
Sure, but I don't think they had...
Okay, Orange... If they lose this game, dude, this is 100% Orange's fault now.
No, I mean, Orange is a boss.
It's not a bad deck.
I think
it's a really bad deck.
Why is it a bad
deck? Because they have armor.
It's never a good deck.
They have a fraction.
It's a perfect deck in game.
It's never a good deck.
I don't think that matters. I mean, obviously, you're not going to dag on the guy with Refraction.
Yeah, but I mean,
I'm just saying it's never a good dag in game. Like, he could go Midas and buy a Force, and then he's like way more useful.
I'm just saying that he has Lifestealer, he has Ember, and then he has Sardar, so physical damage is not going to be a problem at any point in this game.
I think the only valid reason for buying Dagon here is making his opponents mad.
Yeah, I mean that is pretty. I think
you guys are just narrow-minded here.
I'm actually trying to be pretty open-minded here.
Oh,
they're gonna really like hit in, but
I think Entrance is gonna kill the Wisp right now, actually.
Yeah, Dagon.
Glimpse him back. Okay.
Why is he not tethered?
I don't know.
Check the Dagon out.
Alright, we're gonna see it.
The Dagon's coming up with a KS!
Oh, Zai was right.
Thank you.
Sorry.
I mean, I don't see how you could ever say that it's bad to buy a Dagon. I mean, it's, what is it, 400 magic damage as burst.
300 basically. It's not very good, I think.
So, I mean, you're playing this game and all you need to do literally is just keep killing your opponents.
Yeah, but that's like a 4 stuff, dude. You're just like... throw your ulties out and then force away on one of them. It basically does 300 damage.
I mean, I don't
think. For example, if you're ulti right now and you see a dagger on the chest.
Of course, it's like you're mentally tilting. I mean, they're already checked out of this game, like I said. They don't need a dagger to check them out.
Like the nail on the coffin. It's like fucking done.
I just think that adding 400 extra magic damage to your lineup is never a bad thing.
I think it's definitely there's better things to spend money on, I would say.
Sure.
You just want to buy Dagon on entry.
I wish I could. I wish I could, but I have to buy 4 stuff, so you guys get saved.
The support high horse, huh?
4 stuff, please.
I've heard this one before, the support high horse.
So I admire Orange and his
I think
his courage
straight
to go
up
against
BM.
To go against what purple and teal wants from him.
I wouldn't be surprised if there were the ones behind it, to be honest.
We're gonna find no tail. There's probably a relocate if Wisp is nearby, but it might be too late. And he's actually bottom.
He's farming that.
And they're gonna find TA as well. He's gonna get glimpsed. He's gonna get dusted up. He's not gonna get the Alpha Wolf.
That's a VP disruptor right there. It's a very scary hero. Get the VP.
And VP are gonna group up. They might go for the tier 2 tower or they might go for Roshan. I think we can do both. Roshan is probably a bit harder.
Wait, he has arcane boots?
That's for the 8 element.
Oh.
I see it's coming together now.
It's all coming together.
No, that's for mana pool, dude.
Yeah.
So you can dag him.
Yeah, that's what I said. And he's going 8 elements now.
Is he?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
That's a build.
They swapped right on top of the ward.
This could be good for OG.
Yeah, it could be. They just picked up the blink on that, right?
It also could not matter, but...
let's not do that.
No.
They also smoke up. Let's see if they can predict where VP wants to go, but they're on the opposite side of the map pretty much.
I
wonder if they knew they smoked under a ward. The way they moved, it feels like they are baiting OG into a position.
I think what their thought was...
Is that what it looks like?
No, it does look like they're all just sitting there.
I think their thought was that they're going to smoke, they're going to go through Roche. Actually, no, I don't know what their thought was. Fuck that.
Regardless, there's going to be a fight here, I think.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, both teams smoked. Have that popped. Oh, the centaurs.
Oh, the centaurs.
Oh, my God.
Oh, the match.
Good reaction from this ward.
Nice relocate.
It's a nice relocate, but CK's trapped on the side.
He
has been caught on the side.
Oh, the dig can come into play.
No
my God. This is good. This is good. I'm the toggling.
Everybody. Oh, Orange, bro. Dagging him, bro.
Oh, he got stunned. He's dead.
I swear finish.
The problem is Ember and Nyx are still going ham.
No, they're almost dead here. Wisp, can you finish off the life steer?
Wisp is gonna finish off the life steer, he said.
That's not gonna happen. Barrier blinks away.
That was probably, honestly, that was a pretty good situation for OG. Like, considering that the bat didn't even get the initiation off, and they got 2 for 4.
Well, the problem is, with a hero like Bat Rider, if you botched the initiation, you're not gonna come back and be the best team fighting hero, are you?
Well, I mean, he didn't really botch it, he just blinked away from the Slardar.
Yeah.
And then it was a very fast relocate out by Jerax.
Yeah, problem was the Seeker was still stuck in the storm.
If they can start the fight on someone like...
Well, what I mean is that...
Drag them out of position, like a Lifestealer, I think that's the best way to go.
The lasso is like his biggest strength, right?
If they see him blink out, they're not afraid of just going in.
Yeah, that's true.
I do think that location is probably the best place for Rudy to fight. Just somewhere that the back and last of the life starter.
I don't know, I think they need to protect this TA, because he's realistically the only burst damage.
Oh, they're on his case right now.
Yeah, they have a ward.
He should
OG
get out.
They don't have any vision, right, VP?
TA did not care at all.
I don't think they probably sentry the area, right?
Actually, he is not caring at all.
He's just hitting ancient.
That is the fact.
He's just farming, bro.
You just trade your life.
They're in the same now with that ward.
Trade your life.
Barrett is here. I think he has.
Barrett has last.
This is a pretty good location for OG here. But it's only a disruptor.
This is where you
though.
Wish you had a 4 step on your fellow support. This is where disruptor is crying. Force me, Inch.
He's gonna die to Roche though.
Yeah,
I bet Orange just left.
Oh my God.
I got the Heather.
See that dagger? Yeah, I saw it.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Look at him go, dude.
He thinks he's up there, but he's actually dead. Alright, not not great.
They'll probably finish off.
They only got.
Oh, good reactions from his four. Yeah.
If they can try to start a fight with the lasso and putting Lifesteer up there, because they have the four stuffs. So
yeah, if it was like Lifesteer up there, that would have actually been super good for them.
Well, the problem is he can't.
He can't go on someone besides Disruptor.
He can.
He might have some time. Like, if Lifesteer's in the worst position possible.
Glimpse doesn't.
He doesn't have force yet, though, so it's kind of hard.
True, but if it was a Lifesteer there, he would have been on the cliff.
Yeah, true. It's a very. Situation.
Yeah, but it's like the only situation where I see OG coming on top of a fight, or at least having a decent
chance. I think that's never gonna happen.
Sorry.
I don't want to be negative. I'm
just trying to be positive here.
Well, I think there's a difference between being positive and being unrealistic.
No.
You guys are like actually like faking.
I think we're. I think we're lucky to have a game with 40 kills at minute 18.
You just can't tell the difference between calling something over and not hoping for the possible.
You know what? Nakes can just sit there, don't hit Tia for like 20 seconds, and she keeps attacking him, and he still won't die.
That's true.
That's the situation right now. And
not 20 seconds.
Yeah,
wait,
literally 20 seconds, dude.
I'll correct that to 14.5 seconds.
Well, everyone's entitled to their opinions.
Keep that in mind. Keep that in the calculations.
I will calculate this, sir.
Do it.
Look, well, at least VP, I don't know if they can go high ground necessarily, so they have some... Okay, he just went back for the mech.
I think if they
have a cool build.
If they have Aegis, they can go high ground. Just put it on Lifestealer. Ember's just going to sit in the back and W everyone who walks in. And at this point, OG's heroes are all very vulnerable to Ember Spirits.
So would you say this is GG?
He is twice... No. I'm not saying that at all.
Okay, sorry.
I'm saying Ember Spirit is twice the net worth of TA. Four times the net worth of Treant.
This game is in OG's bag.
I would say the problem about Ember being high net worth is that the hero is like always, like it's always possible for it to die. Obviously, it's not easy to get to him, but if they catch him, you can actually die.
Yeah, but the problem, I feel like it depends on how far he is, because if Bat lassos him, and like they have no blinks, like I don't think TA has a blink, I'm not positive though.
It's hard.
The Chaos Knights, although he has a Wisp, I suppose.
I would argue that it's always possible for every hero to die. But maybe that's just
what is wrong with you?
It's almost always possible.
I mean, I don't know. It's not easy for Ember to die this game. I don't.
It's
think.
Not easy at all.
I think I think the bat has to be super close to the Chaos Knight. I don't think they want to use relocate like that. Like where they relocate into
a lasso. No, that's not against.
That's like the
work up here, Sadar.
Yeah. So VP's gonna go. They have.
Oh yeah, I don't think they saw it.
They don't have what's happening right now.
They have Dagon.
Dagon's great.
That's a good mode right there. This is a good position. Like if he can get the lasso on the Ember when he's to the left and
wait, they just bought sentries coming.
Oh, what the?
What happened?
He's spot up though.
This is it.
Disruptor's
dead.
Need to kill yellow. Oh, Dagon.
He just died back, so...
Yes, sir.
I still really believe that OG can win this game.
You're just being mean at this point.
Yeah, you actually are, man.
I'm sorry, but I was just trying to...
I think...
prove my point.
There's no point to be proven here. I think VP is very far ahead in this game. OG kind of had their last stand there. CK buying out and dying again.
That was probably like... That was probably their best shot, but it's so hard to play Chaos Knight in this game against Ember Spirit. He's way too farmed. So it's like your ulti doesn't do that much. You as a hero doesn't. It doesn't feel like.
My sources tell me that 9 out of 10 games it's hard playing Chaos Knight.
9 out of 10?
Yeah.
Right. Well, it's just about getting ahead and farm,
about
you know.
The fish is a better hero than Chaos Knight.
The problem what you have is that their heroes are very snowball in this game. They're like far behind. So
why did they want Chaos Knight? What do you think? Just to win the trial? Because I don't think Chaos Knight is that good of a hero to like, even though he has illusions against Lifestealer or anything. It just doesn't seem like you would want him.
And I guess they went for some kind of like negative armor strap with TA and CK, and if they get a lasso on this on anyone in the game, they can possibly blow them up with illusions and meld and all that kind of stuff.
I think the idea from them was that they just wanted a type of draft where they're not falling behind, so like they can control the game.
Yeah.
But
they
didn't
wanted
really
to get
work out
pretty aggressive, really.
Yeah, they wanted to get aggro and like just like get a snowball going.
Yeah.
It's funny how like they wanted to start the momentum by smoking down middle lane, and there's just they ended up losing 3-1.
Yeah.
As an Ember expert, what do you think about his build, Arthur?
I think he should got a blink, right? I think Blink is generally always really good.
Does he need a blink?
I mean, he could just get Lincoln's. He's like immortal. He's basically unkillable.
I feel like Ember actually plays like the face of his opponents this game. He's not like the kind of Ember.
But Blink kind of helps with that too. You can just go on top of those.
Sure,
Lincoln's.
Oh, this is good. Slaughter is in trouble.
Yep, Slaughter down. But TA just needs to die.
TK is doing work.
The problem is that Ember has Aegis here and a DD. He literally had a DD for this fight, so.
Alright, if OG get out, it's not too bad.
Just gonna be a glimpse.
Ember has ultis, or?
He's not gonna make it. No, he's out.
Oh, they actually
no glimpse? No, they don't have vision.
Ah.
That was very good, I think.
It was
pretty good, yeah.
Okay,
that was
pretty good. That was good considering the
as good as it
here.
Gets for them right now.
Yeah.
I mean, it was good in the sense that they killed Charter, it was bad because they had to use both their cores. Yep.
Like I said, man, it's all up to S4 to carry this game.
Yeah.
And that
I
was
think
Aegis.
Has the potential to carry this game.
I guess they got Aegis as well.
Yeah, they got Aegis.
It's not all bad. But
he almost has his Lincolns. Yeah. Holy crap, man! He's got Greaves. He's actually so farmed.
He switched up the build.
He used Dagon as a Midas. It looked like.
He has 800
heroes.
HP.
I mean, there's 37 kills in this game, which is quite a lot.
No, that's on one of his teams.
50.
There's actually 50.
50 kills.
Wait, what?
There's
50
kills.
I'm saying VP
on
has
their
37.
Side, yeah.
Oh,
sorry. So I thought you were talking about the game.
No, I'm saying.
Oh, S4.
I think that's the tankiest hero, right? Why would he go on the entrenches?
Inch? He has 800 HP.
It's
a
buyback from S4.
Tails dead as well. Destructor might. Oh, he's good.
I mean, obviously, Lifestar is the tankiest, but like. I guess they're just doing some YOLO plays right now. Try to stall the end of this game here.
At this point, they're just like hoping for.
Oh, that is a dieback from S4. Wisp is probably going down here. Relocate, but he comes back. Ember is just having a good time here. It's a team wipe.
GG. Okay. Well played to VP.
Yeah. Showing that they are unbeatable.
VP have won the Summit 6.
No, I think VP just played a lot better than every team at this tournament.
Yeah, I think they're definitely super good right now. They're on another level.
They weren't scared to play against any hero.
Yeah.
They had their own strats
right
down.
I mean, no, it's just Summit, guys. You know, they win every Summit, I think.
No, they didn't win Summit 4.
I think it's a bit early to call VP the new Winx.